Good evening, students. Morning, we have discussed about finding the increase or decrease percent and finding discounts and discount percentage. In this video, let us discuss about profit and loss, what we have already learnt in 7th standard. Let us recall profit and loss through the story.
Sam's mom and dad have given him two of their brand new watches. Sam is on his way to the market to sell the watches. His dad has asked him to sell the watches for a profit and not a loss. What did he mean by profit and loss? Let's find out. Suppose you spend certain money to buy or make a toy. The price at which you make or buy the toy is called its cost price. Now, you decide to sell the toy for some amount of money. The price at which you sell the toy is called its selling price. When the selling price of the toy is more than its cost price, it means you get more money than you spend on the toy. The difference between the two prices is called profit. However, when the cost price is greater than the selling price, it means that you make less money than what you spend on the toy. The difference between the two prices is called loss. Now, let's see whether Sam sells the watches for a profit or a loss. The price tag on his dad's watch shows Rs. 700 and that on his mom's watch shows Rs. 600. What do we call these prices? Cost price is correct. The price with which we buy is called the cost price. Hope Sam earns a good profit on the watches. Sam is back from the market. He seems to have sold the watches for a good price. How much did you sell your dad's watch for? Sam says he sold his dad's watch for Rs. 850. Did he earn a profit? Yes, he did, because the selling price, Rs. 850, is greater than the cost price, Rs. 700. Sam earned a profit. Now let's find out how much profit Sam earned on his dad's watch. To calculate the profit, we subtract the cost price from the selling price. Subtracting 700 from 850, we get 150. So, Sam earned a profit of Rs. 150. Sam still has his mom's watch with him. He did not seem to have sold this watch. Let's look at the watch, Sam. Oh, the strap of this watch seems to be broken. How much did the shopkeeper offer you for selling this watch, Sam? Sam says the shopkeeper is offering him Rs. 350 for this watch. The cost price of this watch is Rs. 600. If Sam would sell the watch, would he earn a profit? No, he wouldn't. The cost price of the watch is Rs. 600 and the selling price of the watch is Rs. 350. Because the cost price is greater than the selling price, Sam would make a loss if he sold the watch. Let's calculate the loss that Sam would make if he sold the watch to the shopkeeper. To calculate the loss, we subtract the selling price from the cost price. Subtracting 350 from 600, we get 250. So, Sam would have made a loss of Rs. 250 if he sold the watch to the shopkeeper. So, he decided not to sell it. Summing up, we can say that if the selling price of an item is more than the cost price, the difference between the two prices is called profit. And if the cost price of an item is more than the selling price, the difference between the two prices is called loss.
Hope you have understood about profit and loss. Profit means selling price must be greater than cost price. So profit is equal to selling price minus cost price. Loss means cost price will be greater than selling price. So loss is equal to cost price minus selling price. How to find the profit and loss we know. What is meant by overhead charges? So extra charges. We are when buying some things that included cost price, we will spend some other things like repairs, labor charges, transportation. Like these charges are called overhead charges. This overhead charges must be included in cost price. Now let us see how to find out profit percentage and loss percentage through the story.
I have never been so confused in my life. I must talk to profit and loss. Profit, loss, you there?
Yes, we are.
What's the problem? Profit is here to help.
And so is loss.
Well, we started learning profit and loss at school today. And my teacher asked me a question about profit and loss percent.
So,
I was stumped. What is this thing?
Okay, let's call somebody who can help you. Percent?
Yes, did anybody call?
We did. JC here doesn't know who you are.
I know who he is. I just don't know how to use him. Hi, I'm JC.
Hi, JC. Don't worry. I'll teach you all about profit and loss percent. First, tell me this. If Ram bought a pen for rupees 10 and sold it for rupees 20, what is his profit?
Oh, I know. It's rupees 10.
How?
Because profit is selling price minus the cost price.
Good! And if Shyam bought a book for rupees 40 and sold it for rupees 50, what is his profit?
It's rupees 10 again.
Excellent! Now, the actual profit in both cases is rupees 10. But in reality, one of them has made a bigger profit.
But how's that possible? Both of them made a profit of rupees 10.
Percentage, we called you here to explain things to our friend JC. And you're confusing him even more.
Wait. I'm not done yet. Even though the actual profit for both of them is rupees 10, for one person, the profit is a bigger part of the cost price than the other. That person has made a bigger profit. We calculate this profit as percentage of the cost price. Let's calculate profit percent for Ram and Shyam, and then you'll understand it better. To calculate profit percent, you divide the profit by the cost price and multiply it by 100. Let's use this formula to calculate profit percent for Ram and Shyam. Ram made a profit of 100% and Shyam made a profit of 25%.
So even though the profit in both cases was rupees 10, Ram has made the bigger profit based on the cost price.
Perfect!
Yes! Very good!
Thanks, percent. What about loss percent? How do we calculate loss percent?
Just like profit, the amount of loss two people make may be the same. But the loss of one might be bigger than another's based on the cost price. And for that, we can calculate loss percent.
The formula for loss percent is the same as that for profit percent. Only Profit is replaced with loss.
Remember, all percentage calculations are based on the cost price.
Great! Thanks all of you. That was brilliant. I understand it now.
Why are you thanking these two, JC? I was the one who helped you.
Oh, really? And who was it that called you here, huh?
You wouldn't have called me here if you could explain all this to JC.
Loss, come on. I think it's time to teach him a lesson.
It's time to revise all that we learned about profit and loss percent. To calculate profit percentage, you divide the profit by the cost price and multiply it by 100. To calculate loss percent, you divide the loss by the cost price and multiply it by 100. Remember, profit and loss percent are always calculated on the cost price.
So to find a profit percentage, the formula is profit amount by cost price into 100. So to find loss percentage, loss amount by cost price into 100.